run test for two samples. So here also we are going to use two samples, means two independent samples. What do you mean by independent samples? You are going to consider two samples, x1, x2, xn1, y1, y2, yn2, where they are of different sizes. So each test, you know that each test is going to involve some fixed steps, which are nothing but describing the data and the population, writing the null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, test statistic and decision. Now we are going to describe the sample data. We are going to draw two samples of different sizes with two populations with PDFs, FX and FY. Let x1, x2, xn1 be a sample drawn from a population with PDF, FX, and y1, y2, yn2 be another sample of size n2 drawn from a population with PDF, FX, FY. Now after that you should write the null hypothesis. As you know that null hypothesis is indicated with H0. In all the non-parametric tests, the null hypothesis for two sample case is nothing but two samples are drawn from same population. Two samples are drawn from same population. So this is a fixed null hypothesis for two sample case. If it is a one sample case, the null hypothesis is median is equal to the specified value. If as it is a two sample case, the null hypothesis is the two samples are drawn from same population. That is, symbolically the two PDFs are equal. That is, fx is equal to fy. Against the alternative hypothesis, fx not equal to fy. After this, you should focus on the test statistic. As this is run test, we are going to use number of runs as the test statistic. You know that run is nothing but a sequence of letters of one kind followed by the other kind. So you to identify the number of runs here, first of all you should get a sequence. Sequence is nothing but an arrangement. Try to arrange the two samples. You are drawing two different samples, arrange the two samples in an either increasing order or decreasing order of their magnitude. Okay, then you will get, like, let us say that you are given with x1, x2, xn1, y1, y2, yn2, no? If you arrange in the increasing order, the first smallest observation will be placed and the least, like this. You are going to get a sequence of x and y's. So after arranging the two samples in their ascending order of their magnitude, you are going to get a sequence. From this you should identify a run. Run is nothing but a sequence. Here you have x1, so this is a run. Okay, write that with A. If it is, the x1 is from the first sample, no, and indicate that with A, this with B. A. If the particular observation is from first sample, write that as A, otherwise B. Then you will get a sequence of A's, B. Then identify the number of runs. This is a run, 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 run. Then let R be the number of runs in this sequence. Number of runs. This R is going to follow a normal distribution with parameters. Expectation of R and variance of R, where expectation of R is given by 2n1 n2 by n1 and n1 plus n2 plus 1, and variance of R is nothing but 2n1 n2 into 2n1 n2 minus n1 minus n2 by n1 plus n2 whole square into n1 plus n2 minus 1. Then what is the test statistic? Always we indicate with Z, which is given by R minus expectation of R by root over variance of R follows n0 1. After writing the test statistic, to arrive to a decision to accept or reject null hypothesis, you should compare Z with Z alpha by 2. You compare mod Z with Z alpha by 2, the critical value. Whenever mod Z is less than Z alpha by 2, we accept H0, otherwise we reject H0. So better understanding on this problem, let us go to a numerical problem on this. So what is the problem given to you? A problem on run test. The following is the data related to temperature in degrees in two places. So you are given with two samples. The data indicates the temperature on two different places. Test whether the two places have the same temperature or not using run test. So it is clear, non-parametric test. The test which you should use will be given to you clearly. Here for testing the hypothesis, you should make use of run test. Come to an idea that whether this is a one sample case or two sample case. As the temperature on two different samples are given, clearly it is a run test on two samples. So for that, what is n? This is place 1. On place 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, count the number of observations on place 1 and name that as n1, and count the number of observations on place 2, that is going to be the n2. So here n1 is nothing but 41 and n2 is also 42. N1 is 21 and both are equal number of observations here. N1 is 21 and n2 is 21. So the first step you should write is nothing but null hypothesis. What is the question here? Test whether the two places have same temperature or not. So the null hypothesis is the two places have same temperature. Whatever the question is given to you, the null hypothesis you are going to write the same. H1 is nothing but the two places have not same temperature. To test that, you are going to use the run test. What is the test statistic in run test? Z is equal to R minus expectation of R by root or variance of R follows N01. Write the formulas for E of R and V of R, and R indicates here number of runs. So how do you identify the number of runs? What I said, if it is a two sample case, as you are given 21 observations on place 1 and another 21 observations on place 2. Run is nothing but sequence of letters of one kind. For that, try to get a sequence. Sequence is nothing but an arrangement. Such an arrangement that club the observations of the temperatures on place 1 as well as place 2. That is, arrange the two observations in the ascending order of their magnitude. So compare, this is from on place 1 you have the observations as this from 21, 38 and 16, and this is the another set. From all these observations, identify the least observation. I think 16 is the least observation here. So from these two observations, 16 is the least observation here. So write that. Okay. Next least is nothing but 18. Better you write, it is from place 2, no? So indicate that on the top of the number with B. So next least is nothing but 19. We have two 19s from place A as well as place B. Write those two. And one you write with A and other write with B, as both are from place A and place 2. Next least observation is 20. You write the least observation and it is from A. Next least is nothing but 21. Okay, 21 is the least one and it is from again place A. Write A with that. And next least is nothing but 22. We have 22 on here and with respect to place 2, you have two 22s. Those two are again from A only. So after 22, what is the next least one? Next least one is 23. I think we have another 22 on B also. Write that B. And 23 is the least one and it is from sample. We have 123 from place B and 123 from place A. So write two 23s. Right, A1 for one sample and another. You continue for all these. So we get, after 23, we have 3 24s. Out of those, 2 are from place A and 1 is from place B. And another 24 we have from B. And next least is nothing but 26. And we have 5 26 if you observe. Out of those 5 26, 3 are from place A and 3 are from place B. So write all the 526 and we have observed that out of those, okay, we have 3 are from place 1. So we are writing A on the top and 2 are from place B. And we have next least as 27 and it is from place A. Next to 28 we have 2, one is from A and one is from B. And you continue the same pattern. So we have arranged all the observations, 21, 22, totally 42 observations in a single sequence in the increasing order of their magnitude, and we are writing on the top of the observation. If the particular observation is from first sample, we are writing that with A, and we are writing that with B if it is from second sample. So we got from the numbers, we got A. Then we have reduced the sequence into alphabets to identify the number of runs. Just I am violating the number of observations there. Simply I am writing the A's and B's to identify the number of runs. So let us see how to identify. So I think B, these two is going to one run. You should consider the same set of alphabets. A is another one. This is one run. Okay, 2, 3, this entire A's are going to be another run, B is going to be another run, 6, B is going to be another run here, 8, and this is another run, 10, 2 B's, 11, 10, 2 B's, 11, I think you got how to identify the runs. On the whole, we got 22 runs here. Okay, the number of runs here we have identified as number of runs R is equal to 22. And what is the for Z? Z is R minus expectation of R by root over variance of R follows N01. So what is the formula for expectation of R? This is 2n1 n2 plus n2 plus 1. Variance of R is 2n1 n2 into 2n1 n2 minus n1 minus n2 by n1 plus n2 whole square. These are the formulas for E of R and V of R. So we have identified R. Again, these are involving N1 and N2. What are N1 and N2? N1 is nothing but the first sample size, and N2 is nothing but second sample size. What is N1 and N2? We wrote in the beginning, N1 is nothing but 21 and N2 is nothing but again 21. From those, we got R as 22, and expectation of R is nothing but 2 into 21 into 21 by 21 plus 1, which is nothing but 924 by 42. Okay, and V of R is nothing but, by putting the values N1 and N2 in the respective formula, we get N1 plus N2 whole square is 21 plus 20 whole square, N1 plus N2 minus 1. On the whole, on simplification, we get this as 10.2439. We got variance of R and expectation of R. Now let us put in Z. What is Z? Z is R minus expectation of R. R is 22 minus, here it is nothing but 22. by 10.2439. So which is nothing but 0. As Z is 0, what is Z alpha by 2 always? Z alpha by 2 is 1.96. As mod Z is less than Z alpha by 2, we accept H naught. So what is H naught? H naught is here. The two places have the same temperature. Okay? Thank you.